and Rich Kids. Today we are going to play a game. These cotton balls represent sheep, and the game we're playing is we are going to throw these cotton balls into the two cups. If it gets in the first cup, you score 1 point. If it gets in the second cup, you score 2 points. Okay, let's do this. today we are going to sing some praises to God.
Flatbread called naan. One of the largest exports are woven rugs. 75% of Afghans cannot read or write, and the most dominant religion is Islam.
Eli just told us some interesting facts about Afghanistan. Let's pray for the people there. Okay? Pray with me, okay? I'm gonna go first, and then it'll be your turn. God, thank you so much for this country of Afghanistan and the people there. God, you love them, and you want them to know you. God, we pray that they would hear about Jesus. God, we know that there are some Christians there. We pray that you would protect them, that you would help them know your love, and that you would give them chances to tell other people about Jesus. Okay, now you pray. God, thank you for your love for all people. And we pray these things in Jesus' name, amen. Good job. Last week we heard how Jesus would use stories called parables to help us learn about his kingdom and more about God. And we learned that his kingdom is growing like a plant and that it's valuable like treasure. You see, I've got some treasure here. And today we're gonna hear some more stories. And these parables are gonna teach us more about what God is like and how God loves us. We're gonna hear a story about a coin and a woman who loses her coin and how she searches until she finds it. And it's gonna show us how God loves us and celebrates when he finds us. So let's watch.
Hello friends, my name is Megan and my name is Jesse. Megan, check out this coin I found.
Oh, cool. That is a quarter, Jesse. It's worth 25 cents.
Nice! I was walking outside and I saw something shiny on the ground. It was this quarter.
That is great. What a good find.
In today's Bible story, Jesus told a parable about a woman with 10 silver coins.
Oh, another parable! I remember that a parable is a story that Jesus told to help people understand something about God or his kingdom.
Wow, what a great memory, Jesse. That's right. Today's Bible story actually has three parables. All three parables taught about God's love. Listen to the story.
Many people came to listen to Jesus teach. The religious leaders were angry that sinners came to listen to Jesus. They did not think Jesus should be friends with people who do wrong things. So Jesus told them three parables, or stories, to teach them about God. Jesus said, "If a man has 100 sheep and one goes missing, he leaves the 99 sheep and looks everywhere for his lost sheep. And when he finds it, he tells his friends and neighbors, 'Let's celebrate because I have found my lost sheep.'" Jesus told them, "In heaven, there will be more joy over one person who is sorry for his sin and turns back to God than over 99 good people who don't need to be sorry." Then Jesus told a second story. If a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one of them, she lights a lamp, sweeps the house, and searches until she finds it. Then she tells her friends and neighbors, "Let's celebrate because I have found my lost coin." Jesus said, "In heaven, God's angels will celebrate when one person is sorry for his sin and turns back to God." Then Jesus told one more story. A man had two sons. The younger son told his father, "Give me the money that will be mine someday." So the father gave his son what was his. The younger son traveled to a faraway country. He spent all his money and made wrong choices. The son had nothing left, and the country he was in ran out of food. He got a job feeding pigs, but he was still hungry. The son was sorry for his wrong choices. He said, "My father's workers have plenty of food. I do not deserve to be his son. I will ask to be his worker." So he went home. His father ran to him and gave him a big hug and a kiss. The son started to say he was sorry, but the father told his servants, "Bring the best clothes for my son to wear. Let's celebrate with a big meal. My son was lost, and now he is found." The older son came home and asked, "What's going on?" A servant said, "Your brother is home. Your father is celebrating." The father asked the older son to come inside and celebrate. But the older son was angry. He said, "I always obeyed you, but you never threw a party for me." "Son," the father said, "everything I have is yours. This is a day to celebrate because your brother was lost, but now he is found." Jesus told stories about people who were looking for things that were lost. Jesus told these stories to teach about himself. Jesus looks for people who are lost, people who do not know him. Jesus gave his life to save people from sin.
Do you know what it feels like to lose something that you love? It's really sad. And you search for it and think about how happy you are when you find it. That's how that father felt. He was so sad when his son went away, but he was so happy he ran to his son when he came back. And that shows us how God is. God loves us so much, and he wants to be with us. You know, God says that Jesus is like our friend, and he can be our best friend. He's the best friend that we can have. And I bet you have some friends who don't know Jesus, and we want our friends to know our best friend, Jesus. We can tell them about him. And Jesus loves us so much, and he loves to make new friends. So let's take some time and answer these questions. And we're so glad that you joined us today, and we hope you'll join us next week too. See you later, bye.